So sometimes it's hard to know what to cook for yourself or someone you're looking after. Now you'll find my great recipes on the site, but I've actually cajoled four very dear friends of mine, Baz, Ben and Jamie, and Mike is behind the camera.
Cajoled?
Cajoled.
I had to be really persuaded.
Herded.
Yeah. Okay, well, spill the beans then. Do you remember how we met?
So Jane was looking after a friend of ours for a really tough part of his life. And because of that, it kind of showed to us how important, firstly, your kind of guidance was, but also the food that he was eating. And then in turn, that kind of helped us influence what we cook as well, and realising how powerful that can be in other people's lives.
Yeah. And that's really what we are creating together. It's that whole communication of food, love, passion, all the great recipes. But thinking of sort of childhood memories, what was your greatest childhood memory with food?
I suppose it's the big family gathering, so where you get everybody together around food. So whether it's things like Christmas or birthdays, holidays away, where you've actually got the time to spend with the people that you love, and like as a kid, seeing everybody together and helping out to create the meal, I think that's probably one of the biggest things, and therefore you get the big meals, whether it's roast dinners or Christmas dinners, that kind of thing.
And it's really sort of creating that synergy between care and love and passion of food, and that's what we're all about. Where would you say you'd like to see food go?
Our perspective has always been about social. Making it as fun and easy as possible, but also a way of bringing people together. It's kind of, food's always set at the heart of our friendship, and we think it can do the same thing for others. It's just about educating and getting people to understand how easy it is to do. You can make friends off the back of it.
And if you had one favourite recipe that you'd share with a grandparent, what would yours be? What would you cook for them?
So I think sometimes it's taking something that they are already incredibly familiar with, kind of a nostalgic dish, but giving it a new twist. So I find with food, I always want some sort of conversation or conversation start, something to spark off it. So a classic shepherd's pie, but maybe with some Indian spices in this, like a curry shepherd's pie. So they recognise something that they've always known and loved, but with a new twist that just sparks a new conversation and gets people talking around food in a different way than they may have previously experienced.
Depending on how old they are, you don't want to surprise them too much.
Less is more.
Exactly.
Less is more. A little surprise in a life, that's fine. So let us know what you think. Come and see the recipes, see sorted food. These guys are crazy, as you know. And they're always coming up with new ideas. So between us, we'll create stuff that you want. So just communicate with us.